Hello everyone. In this module, I'm going to demonstrate how to implement predefined interfaces while creating Aura component in Lightning. So let's jump to developer console. I am creating one Lightning component. So while creating Lightning component, here you can see a component configuration is available. So if you create bundle with any of the following configuration, so you can choose any of the options. So these all are optional. So you can select zero or more as per the requirement. So let's say name of this component is Hello World. Now, if you want to place your Lightning component on Lightning tab, so you need to enable this. If you want to place it on Lightning page, so you have to enable this option. For record page, third option. If you want to place your component on Experience Builder site page, so this option. And if you want to launch your Lightning component through Lightning Quick Action, so you can enable this option. So I am enabling all the options because I will be demonstrating how we can use this Lightning Aura component everywhere. Those are listed here. So here you can see all the interfaces are available. So I'm separating them in different lines so that we can read. So these all are available here. So this component is basically implementing app hostable, available for all page types, available for record home, has record ID. So this basically, this is an additional one. So if you have this one, so if you place this component on any record page, so that record ID will be available automatically in this component. So for that, you will be creating a attribute named as record ID. So in that record ID attribute, automatically, the currently opened record ID will be available. Then we have Force Community that is available for all page types. It is for community or site. Then Lightning Quick Action and access is global. Now inside this, I'm creating one paragraph. So this is my Lightning component, right? So this message I'm putting inside P tags. So I have saved this Lightning component. Now I don't want to preview this Lightning component to Lightning app. I will be placing it on different places, right? So moving to application. So let's create a tab first. So here you can see Lightning Components tab option is available. If I click on New, so from here I can select the component. So we created Hello World as a component, so I'm able to select it. Now I can label it as per the requirement. So demo component, then we can select particular style. If you want to fill the description, so you can do that. Then click on next. So this is visibility for the profile. So if you want to apply one tab visibility for all profiles, so you can select these options here. Three options are available: default on, default off, and tab hidden. So I'm selecting as default on. Apply a different tab visibility. So if you want to apply a different tab visibility for a particular profile, so you can select second option. So I'm selecting first option, clicking on save. So here you can see Lightning component tab is created and its name is demo component. So let's refresh the page. Now here, if I try to search it, so it is available. If I click on this, so you will see your Lightning component message. So here it is, right? So I just provided a dummy message. So that's why it is available here. If you apply any CSS, so it will be attractive as well. So now if you want to place this tab on particular application, so that is also possible. So for that, we need to move to App Manager. So I'm going to place it on sales application and so I edited sales application. So now I need to select that. So navigation items and here demo component will be available. Selecting it, placing it. So here you can see at the bottom it is available. Clicking on save. So it is saved, moving back, coming here and refreshing the sales application. So at the end you will see demo component tab will be available. So here it is. So now you don't need to search it in App Launcher. It is available with this application always. So this way our first part is complete. Like if I try to create new Lightning component, so how we can create Lightning tab. So this I demoed. Now Lightning page. So for that, I am searching for Lightning App Builder. So from here, I will be creating a new app page and I will be placing this Lightning component on that page. So if you have any Lightning page created, so these Lightning Aura components will be available there as well. So selecting app page, clicking on next, labeling it as demo app page, clicking on next. Now here we need to select the format. So I'm selecting header and left sidebar, clicking on finish. So here at left hand side, you can see standard components are available. And if I scroll down to bottom, so here custom components are available. So I just need to drag and drop it. So it will be available. If you want to place it in this section, so you can do that as well. Click on save. Now we need to activate it. So activate for all user, activate for system administrator only. So it depends on your requirement. Then Lightning experience. So we need to select particular application. So I'm selecting sales. So this demo app page will be available in the sales application. Moving it to bottom. So, yep. It is not moving to bottom, so let's put it here only. Clicking on save, moving to back. So here on the sales application, you won't see that app tab. So I'm just refreshing this. So after doing multiple refreshes, that app page will be available here. So if I click on this, so here you can see demo app page, and this is the Lightning component message, which is displayed. So this way, if you create any Lightning component, so you can create an app page and you can place that component on that page. And then you can add that page into particular application. So second part is completed. Now I'm going to demo you how you can place this Lightning component on record page. So for that, I'm clicking on account, opening particular account, and I will be placing that component on this account record page. So clicking on this gear icon, clicking on edit page. So So at the bottom here, you can see this component is available to place. So I just need to drag and drop it. So here it is placed. Now I can click on save. So I'm assigning it as org default, clicking on save, moving back. So now if I open any account record, so here you can see whatever features are available in that Lightning component, those will be displayed here. So right now we have mentioned a particular message. So this is displayed here. So as per your Lightning component, it will be shown here. Now, next is community. So right now I don't have any community created in this org. So if you create any community, so you will be able to place this Lightning component on that community or site as well. So you just need to drag and drop like we did here in the record page or app page. And last we have Lightning quick action. So if you create any quick action, so through that also you can launch this Lightning component. So what I can do, moving to Object Manager, clicking on Account, Button Links and Actions. Now clicking on New Action. So from here, we need to select action type. So here we have two options, Lightning Component and Lightning Web Component. So you need to select Lightning Component because it is based on Aura. Then Lightning Component name is automatically available here. Height, you can decide, then label. So demo Lightning Component, clicking on save. So it is created. Now what you need to do, you need to open account object again. You need to open page layout. Then on page layout, you can just place that quick action. So click on mobile and Lightning action. And here you can see demo Lightning Component button is available. You can click on save. Now, if I move to accounts and if I open any account record, so here you can see demo Lightning Component button is available. So if I click on this, so it will launch my Lightning Component. So this way you can launch your Lightning Component through quick action. Right, so these are the interfaces that you can use in your Lightning Component so that you can use your Lightning Component on several places. So in this module, I hope you understood how we can use Lightning Component in tabs, in apps, in record page through quick action. So you don't need to create application always. If you want to use your Lightning Component on particular page, so you can just create Lightning Component, use a particular interface as per the requirement, and then you can drag and drop that component as and when required. So this is all about predefined interfaces. Those are available with Lightning Component.